Disintegration of Family, a Shifting Mentality Towards Independence. Independence is an I don't need you attitude, an attitude of selfishness. Independent focused persons are saying not only that they don't need anyone else, but that no one else needs them, therefore reducing or eliminating, if only in perspective or thought, their responsibility to others. If you want to not need anyone else, then you probably don't want anyone else to need you. But what if they do? And perhaps not wanting any responsibility to others is a major motivating factor in the pursuance of independence. Family members can even become more independent with their behavior while being in the same household, spouses and children, each with separate bedrooms, spending time alone rather than together. Parents may feel like their only responsibility is to work and provide resources, and perhaps only dealing with problems when they arise, rather than taking the time each day to ensure that they don't, or at least that they will be less likely. And so they may think, I deserve time alone. An independent-minded parent may also carry over this philosophy to their children when it comes to monitoring their activities, such as the quality of their friends, social media consumption, television, video games, and music. For example, what values, good or bad, are they being exposed to and trained by? Are the parents allowing these things to train their children, perhaps poorly? Or are they teaching their children not only good values, but also the development of discernment, to be on guard for when negativity is being let into the mind? The children's friends may not be monitored by independent parents, since it's their life. They need to develop independence, they may say. And if this doesn't turn out the best, or even poorly, the children may grow up resenting poor parenting, furthering barriers to family cohesiveness, for example, grandparents and grandchildren. Yet another self-perpetuating cycle when children become fully grown and weren't taught how to have a quality relationship or have a bond formed. Simply by not experiencing it means that not only were they not taught the quality relationship or how to bond, but they were taught something inferior to that. Also, when spousal conflicts arise, a group-oriented philosophy of I need you, you need me, and the kids need us will help facilitate reconciliation, while more independent attitudes will allow the conflict to fester. And this leads us to divorce and single-parent households. The thought of the possibility of independence, or the notion that life would be better if I was independent, just makes it easier not to reconcile marriage conflicts and simply choose divorce. And the more society accepts higher divorce rates, by not speaking out against divorce and not teaching our families how to reconcile conflicts, the easier it is to justify, since others will support your divorce, and it therefore becomes a self-perpetuating cycle. The children now see divorce as normal and are therefore somewhat more likely to accept divorce as a viable option. The feminist movement was also responsible for teaching women to think more independently, rather than more family-oriented. Women wanted more power, more freedom, more independence, and therefore less responsibility to the family structure. And it should be no shock to see more pregnancies out of wedlock, more single mothers and single-parent households, along with the creation and expansion of the welfare system, a system that rewards, in some manner of thought, anti-family behaviors, such as pregnancy out of wedlock, single-parent, single-mother households, as well as not earning wages to support the household. And when the children of these households grow up, what values have they been taught? to have a child out of wedlock is okay, because the government will take care of me and my child, and to not work for the same reason. And so the anti-family values are strengthened and spread wider into society. The welfare system is promoting and rewarding independent behaviors and bad values. So if people know they will be rescued after poor decisions, it only makes it easier to engage in risky behavior. Whereas, if they saw bad consequences or were taught to properly foresee consequences in general, they would be more prepared to make decisions that would lead to family cohesiveness and less conflicts. And if they were to find themselves in need of help, they would seek help from their own family, who will want to meet their unfulfilled needs or problems in the short term, but also provide them with the proper guidance to make better decisions in the future. And one could argue that a cohesive, teaching family would probably not face this type of situation because of their value teaching to the children, as well as the children's respect for the family unit in the first place, so as not to put that stress onto the family unit, which is once again a family unit-oriented thinking as opposed to an independent me thinking. And with this proper guidance and better ability for proper decision-making comes the further strengthening of the cohesiveness of the family, as well as the bonds between members and each other and the group, and at the same time making the community stronger, and hopefully turns the tables on self-perpetuating cycles towards the positive good of not only the community, but also the family.